All right, here we are with the first example dealing with payroll. So as you will find out, there's more than one kind of angle to look at this. There's more than one journal entry that we have to do with this. So this one, let's look at the example. Uniform company employs Miss Eva Cruz as a manager. Uniform company pays Miss Cruz an annual salary of $96,000, which calculates out to be about $370 per day. And that's going to be important here in a minute. According to the IRS and state tax tables, and information from her W-4, Ms. Cruz is required to withhold $800 in federal income tax and $300 in state income tax. Uniform company is located in a state where the state unemployment taxes are capped at $7,000. Uniform offers the following benefits to its customers. Uniform company will pay half of its employees' health insurance premiums, which total premiums cost $900 per month. Uniform company will match the employees' retirement contributions up to 4% of the gross pay per month. Uniform company allows employees to earn one day of vacation per month of work. So what did Ms. Cruz actually put in there? Well, she elects to have Uniform withhold $450 per month for health insurance, which is half, the full 4% for retirement, so she gets the match, and $50 for charitable contributions to St. Jude's. So in this one, it asks us to compute Ms. Cruz's net pay for the month of January and journalize the entry. So this one is looking at it from the employee's standpoint. What did Ms. Cruz make and what did she have to pay on her own behalf, which is being withheld? Okay. So first and foremost, we need to start with the gross pay. So our gross monthly salary, well, it gives it to us on an annual basis of $96,000. So we can just take that $96,000 divided by 12 and that'll give us $8,000 in total. So that'll be her gross monthly pay, because remember, we're doing this for January, $8,000. All right, now that we have that, then we can go into the deductions. Now, again, we're going to do this from the hierarchy standpoint. So who gets paid first? Uncle Sam. We'll start with the income taxes. So federal, and in this situation, state, because this gives us both. So federal, they need to withhold, or she is paying on her own behalf, $800 in federal, and then $300 in state. Okay, then we move to the next layer of the hierarchy, which is the FICAs. So we have FICA Social Security and FICA Medicare. Now remember, these come with percentages. We're going to use the standard percentage here, which is going to be for FICA Social Security, 6.2%. So 8,000, which is the gross, times 6.2%. That's going to give me 496. So that's how much she has to pay on her own behalf. And Medicare, it is 1.45%. So 8,000 times 1.45%, that will give you 116. All right, that takes care of that. Now we're at the voluntary withholdings, the stuff that she chooses to do. Okay, and there's three of them here. So we have first, she pays half of her health insurance premium. So we'll put the 450 down because that's coming out of her check. We also have retirement. Now in retirement, she's elected to take out 4% and put it into retirement. So we'll take the 8,000 times the 4%, that gives us 320. And then we have finally the charitable contributions to St. Jude's of $50 per month. If we add all of those up, that'll give us a total deduction of $2,532. Now notice there's some things in here that we didn't include. We didn't do anything with the vacation. We didn't do anything with unemployment because that's not her responsibility. That's the employer side of it. We're really only doing the employee side of it right now. Okay, so now that we have the total deductions, we subtract that from our gross monthly salary, and that will give us our net pay for the month, or what she's taking home in check of $5,468. So she earned $8,000, but she's only taking home $5,468. All right, now that we have the actual calculations done, now let's do the journal entries for the business. Okay, so we're going to start with 131 because that's the date. And we start with the gross monthly salary, the $8,000, because to the business, that's what, for her, that's what she earned. To the business, that's what they have to pay her in order to use her services. So because they used her services, they're going to expense it. We'll call that salaries expense of the gross amount, which is $8,000. And again, the reason one reason I like to do it this way in terms of the equation, or the way it's written out, is everything where it says deductions is going to be your credits. Just put payable behind them. So the next one will be federal income tax of $800. So we'll credit that federal income tax payable. 800. State income tax, we'll do state income tax payable of 300. FICA Social Security, we'll do FICA Social Security tax payable of 496. FICA Medicare tax payable of 116. Health insurance premium payable, or health insurance payable, of 450. Retirement, we'll call it retirement contribution payable, of 320. And then you have charitable contribution payable to St. Jude's of 50. Okay, that takes care of all the deductions. The last thing we need to do, remember, our debits and our credits have to equal, and right now they don't because we're missing the net pay. And that's what the company is paying out to her. And so we're going to put that into salaries payable until we actually cut the check and give it to her or directly deposit it. So that's how you do a payroll example from the employee side of it. In the next videos, we'll talk about from the employer side of it. So please be mindful and keep these separate. But other than that, y'all have a good one.